with breaking news.
We have to begin this morning with that breaking news. Two people have died, three others hurt after a late night shooting. We were the first ones to bring you this live last night.
Yeah, first on the scene. This happened in Smell Riverfront Park. Thousands of people were in the area last night, of course, celebrating, watching fireworks. The 4th of July was last night. Celebrating that, of course, live team coverage for you this morning.
Yeah, so we want to break down all of the latest for you. That team coverage, WLWT News 5's Miana Massey live at UC, where three of the victims were taken. And WLWT News 5's Meredith Stutz live at the scene still, where police are investigating. You will still see a police presence this morning, Meredith.
Yes, good morning to you, Kelly. So we do know that you're going to see police this morning, at least for several more hours, but details are slim about what went down last night. But police estimate about 100 to 500 kids were around Smell Park when that shooting took place. And this is Smell Park, like you were saying, Colin and Kelly. A lot of you may have been down here this weekend celebrating the 4th of July, watching those fireworks when that shooting took place. Now, this is what we're seeing behind me. This is that carousel. Maybe you recognize it, maybe you visited this weekend. Now at the center of a complex homicide case. Police say the shooting came in just after 10:45 last night. Officers were in the process of clearing the park for the night when they heard gunfire. Police report five people shot, including one person found dead in the park. One person later died at UC Medical Center. Police say this scene covers a large area here along the river and say they need your help solving this case.
This is a very big, complicated scene. It spans most of Smale Park, and it will be probably until the morning hours until that investigation, at least from the criminalistic standpoint, is done.
At this point, we really need people that were around, that saw something, if they recorded video, to provide that information to us. Call Crime Stoppers, 352-3040. Everybody knows that number. We also have a tip line where you can submit information through tip 411, so they can go that way and send us information. But you know, trying to piece this together. It's a very, very complicated scene, as the colonel said, and we feel for those that have lost loved ones tonight, the family members who are dealing with that loss.
Now, we do know that there is no word yet on a suspect. We are expected to hear from Cincinnati police later this morning. And as for traffic, if you need to head out on this Monday, we do know that Marion Way is still closed at this hour between Great American Ballpark and Paul Brown Stadium. It is expected to remain closed until late morning hours. Back to you.
Meredith, quickly, with so many kids that you alluded to and people, just families, watching the fireworks last night for July 4th, is there a chance these people might have been targeted? Have police said anything about that?
Well, we specifically asked that last night, and police said that it is too early to tell that. But police said that they did have extra patrol here, Colin, around this area for the 4th of July holiday, and said, in fact, when that shooting took place, that more than 50 officers responded. But again, still no word yet on a suspect. And police say, if you know anything, like you just heard them say, please let them know or call Crime Stoppers, where you can remain anonymous. Back to you.
All right, Meredith Stutz reporting live from Smell Riverfront Park this morning. Meredith, thank you for bringing us that part of the story. We want to, of course, turn our attention back to those victims. Some of them are still in the hospital this morning.
WLWT News 5's Miana Massey at UC with the latest on their conditions. Miana, what are you able to tell us?
Yeah, good morning, Kelly and Colin. So really overnight at this hospital, there hasn't been too much activity. What we do know is that three of those victims out of the five shot last night were taken here to UC Medical. Now, another was taken to Children's Hospital. They say one of those victims died right here at UC Hospital. The other two just had those minor injuries. Now, as Meredith also touched on last night, police were really already in the area. They were helping to clear out after just before 11 o'clock. And they say they quickly responded once those shots rang out. Now, our crews were here at the hospital as those victims arrived. I want you guys to take a look at what we believe are family and friends just waiting for answers. Now, at the scene, we spoke to Pastor Peterson Mingo. He's with the God Squad, and he says his mission is really to provide support to victims and families who've been affected by gun violence. He says in working to heal the community, it all starts within the household. He says it's important to bring prayer back into parenting.
Talk to your children, pray with your children. One of the reasons why there's so much turmoil is that we haven't handed down a legacy of prayer, togetherness, and community, you know, to our children. There's a big gap. Right now, we have children trying to raise children, and as a result, they're not doing such a good job.
Yes, and so Pastor Mingo says they are really just kind of spreading themselves thin with all the kind of gun violence in the area and things like that. He says that it's really important for families to work through this trauma and these situations. He says it's okay, especially for young people, to seek help, seek therapy and support that is available in the community. He says he's there for anyone who just needs to talk or kind of work through situations. I'm Yana Massey here at UC Medical, WLWT News 5.
And Miana, as people wake up this morning or learn the news, they're going to be curious. I know people want answers about the victims. Do we have any information yet? Just lost Miana there as she gets more information. Again, at last check right now, officers just kind of working still to find more information, piece together some of that information, and they haven't released names or ages yet about those victims, but we will bring that to you as we get it. So our team coverage will continue through the morning. All of the latest information up on our website, WLWT.com. You can always download our mobile app for the latest, or again, just visit our website, WLWT.com.